Hey all, welcome to ShareTrek. This is Raj here. Friends, this is the second episode in the series on broadly neutralizing antibodies for HIV. Last video, we covered PGDM 1400, and today I'm going to talk about PGT 121, which is a highly anticipated broadly neutralizing antibody with potential to revolutionize HIV treatment and prevention. This video is going to talk about everything that you need to know about PGT 121, including some estimates of when it's likely to get approved. With that said, let's get started. Welcome back, friends. PGT 121 is a highly anticipated broadly neutralizing antibody. I want to just put a graphic on the top of the screen. I think it's going to come up here. As you can see in this graphic, we already spoke about PGDM 1400. Today, we are which goes into V1, V2 glycan site. Whereas today, we are talking about PGT 121, which is on the right of it, which goes to the V3 super site. So we'll talk about what V3 super site is all about, but I'm going to leave this diagram out here so that you can not only see what we have already finished, that is PGDM 1400, but everything else that needs to come, and you can see it in a complete context so that at the end of this series, you will have a very good understanding of all the BnAB's and how they work. So continuing further, here's a detailed breakdown of the characteristics of PGT 121. And I think one of the main things we need to talk about is its mechanism of action, followed by clinical progress and future directions. So PGT 121 specifically targets a glycan-dependent epitope on the HIV envelope protein GP120. And you guys know the trimer where you have GP120 and GP41. So this goes for to attack the trimer. This epitope lies within V3 loop, and it's a critical region for viral entry into host cells. PGT 121 binds tightly to the V3 loop and surrounding sugars or glycans on GP120, effectively blocking the virus's attachment to the CD4 receptor on the host cells. Not only that, by targeting a conserved region, PGT 121 can neutralize a wide range of HIV-1 strains, hindering the virus's ability to mutate and escape its effects. And preclinical early studies in animal models have shown PGT 121's effectiveness in reducing viral load and HIV infection. These initial human trials, which happened in phase 1, focused on safety and how the body processes PGT 121, which is basically a field called as pharmacokinetics, to see how the body can metabolize it and what happens during, before, and after its interaction with HIV. The results were positive, demonstrating good tolerability and a favorable half-life, suggesting potential for therapeutic use. Now, favorable half-life is something most of you should find very interesting, because half-life indicates how long it the therapy can be effective and remain in the body. Next, we look at the phase 2 trials. The phase 2A trials evaluated PGT 121's efficacy in combination with other BnAB's in HIV-infected individuals. And it demonstrated significant viral load reduction, indicating potent antiviral activity. And this can be found, this actually has been taken from NCT 03205917, which is the clinical trial number. You can search for this on clinicaltrials.gov and you'll get everything that you need out there. The second study assessed PGT 121's preventive potential in high-risk individuals like a PrEP. The results showed significant protection against HIV acquisition. And this was published in Lancet Journal for HIV. And in terms of future outlook, right, most of you are interested in approval timeline, because whenever I publish anything about any HIV therapy, the first question is it getting approved? When will we be able to buy? How much will it cost? So I may not have answers for all the questions, but I'm going to proactively try to address the timeline issue. The timeline of PGT 121's approval depends on ongoing and future trials. With continued positive results, phase 3 trials could commence within the next few years, potentially leading to approval by late 2020. So when we are saying late 2020, we are already in 2024. So we are looking at somewhere around 2028 to 2029, that kind of a time range. So it seems imminent. And when it comes in, it could be both in terms of PrEP as well as in terms of ART. And there is ongoing research that is taking place where PGT-121 is being used in combination therapies. Researchers are investigating the use of PGT-121 in combination with other BnAB's to enhance its effectiveness and prevent viral escape. So in the diagram that you see here on the top, you will see 10-1074-LS and GS-972-2. These are the two BnAB's we are going to talk about in the subsequent videos, but there is a combination therapy that is being tried out there. And studies are exploiting PGT-121's potential role in HIV cure strategies, including shock and kill approaches that aim to eliminate latent HIV reservoirs. In conclusion, I would say that PGT-121 represents a significant advancement in the fight against HIV, and its potent and broad neutralizing activity offers promise for both treatment and prevention strategies, while further clinical trials may be necessary. PGT-121 holds immense potential to transform the future of HIV management if it gets approved by FDA. And as we said, the approval is likely to be somewhere around 2027 to 2029 time range. It's in the later part of this decade. So friends, that's all I have for you today. And I'll come back to you again in the next video with 10G-1074-LS, which is the second item that I have shown in the chart to you up here. And we'll continue with this series until we finish off all the BnAB's that I have in this chart. With that, my friends, I'd like to bring this video to an end. I hope you would press a like out there and you would subscribe. Thanks and have a great day. Bye for now.